The Asian Development Bank envisions the Philippines as a potential carbon exporter. ADB economist David Anthony Reitzer made this remark during the launch of Asian Development Outlook 2023. He lauds the country's relatively low-level baseline carbon emissions. He also urges the country to lessen its dependence on coal.
And the Philippines is coming from a relatively low level of baseline emissions, so it would be among the potential carbon exporters if it doesn't develop too much new coal right now. At the same time, we have seen that the Philippines has rapidly expanded the share of coal in electricity generation. So basically what our report would be urging is that the coal expansion is actually, we don't find that as something that's, under current policies, even economically preferable because of the declining costs of other energy sources. So investing in new coal capacity really is not in the interest of any region.
Meanwhile, the ADB warns there will be large economic losses in developing Asia if high emissions persist. Asian countries were also urged to transition from using coal-based energy to renewable energy to achieve global net zero. Some of the Philippines' tycoons have come together in a bid to upgrade the Ninoy Aquino International Airport. A consortium led by six Filipino conglomerates and U.S.-based global infrastructure partners submitted an unsolicited offer of over 100 billion pesos for the modernization and long-term sustainability of NAIA. The consortium believes this proposal will double the 31 million passengers per annum capacity of the airport. Economic managers earlier said government is eyeing private firms to help in the NAIA rehabilitation.
Manny Pangilinan's Metro Pacific Investments Corporation files for voluntary delisting from the Philippine Stock Exchange. Jackie Pascual with the details.
Metro Pacific Investments Corporation is going private as it filed for voluntary delisting from the Philippine Stock Exchange. This after a tender offer notice was received from a consortium consisting of Metro Pacific Holdings, GT Capital Holdings, MIG Holdings, and Mid Pacific Infrastructure Holdings, which includes Japanese company Mitsui. The consortium offered to buy shares of shareholders at 4 pesos and 63 centavos per common share, a premium of 22% over the one-year volume-weighted average price of MPIC common shares. Bidder said the intrinsic value of MPIC's core investments in infrastructure has not been fully reflected in MPIC's share price for a time. First Pacific Executive Director Christopher Yong said the transaction would benefit shareholders as the company can work with its partners on long-term goals, undistracted by the need to focus on short-term goals that public ownership often imposes. GT Capital Chief Financial Officer Francisco Suarez Jr. says participating in the tender offer will further diversify its core portfolio and aligns with its mission to contribute to nation building. Mitsui, meanwhile, says it will now contribute to energy transition in the Philippines as it also supports MPIC's other businesses. An analyst says it's a good decision for the major stockholders, but maybe not for smaller ones.
It just shows that, I think the major shareholders just realized that MPI is really trading below its intrinsic value, way below. I think the NAV is closer to 8 pesos per share. Mm-hmm. And currently it's trading at about 4 plus, you know, and below 4s. And it's a huge discount to NAV. I think it's like close to 50 or 60%. It makes a lot of sense for the majority shareholders to take this private. But unfortunately for the minority shareholders who are holding this, they would have to make a decision whether to participate in the tender and liquidate their shares or don't participate.
The tender offer values MPIC at 133 billion pesos in equity value. Currently, it owns nearly half of Meralco, more than half of Maynilad, 99.9% of Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation, 20% of Metro Pacific Health Corporation, and other businesses. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signs an executive order creating an office that will manage water resources in the country. The office will be under the Environment Department and is aimed at integrating and harmonizing efforts to ensure the availability of water supply. The office will also serve as a transitory body pending the creation of a Water Resources Department.
Some areas in Metro Manila and nearby provinces have started to experience water supply cuts. As Rafael Busano tells us, low water supply is expected to persist.
Filipinos are finding creative ways to conserve water and use it more efficiently.
Yung init ng katawan, nababawasan pag gaganito ka, konting may heat stroke eh. Yun yung mahirap, yung heat stroke. Pag nadali ka nun, yung mga ganitong panahon talagang kailangan natin yung tubig, napakahalaga niyan. Kaya siguro, sa ano na lang, konti, tipid-tipid lang din.
But getting a steady supply of water remains a problem. Water concessionaire Maynila had to cut back supply in some of their service areas. Residents in some parts of Las Piñas, Muntinlupa, Parañaque, Pasay, as well as in Cavite City, Noveleta, and Rosario in Cavite, will continue to experience water service interruptions until May 16 because of low water production, renewed spikes in turbidity, as well as a leak in a valve of the Putatan Water Treatment Plant 2. Low water supply is expected to persist, which is why government-owned Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System has called on local government units to temporarily suspend water-intensive businesses like resorts, car wash stations, and golf courses. The Metro Manila Council says it will look into the recommendation.
Di naman necessarily ibaban natin lahat ng water-related activities, but we will regulate. At titingnan natin ano ba ang mga activities na sa tingin natin talagang masasabi o matuturing natin nagsasayang ng tubig.
Taking steps to conserve water now will go a long way considering that State Weather Bureau PAGASA says the probability of El Nino or an extended dry spell is high and its effects can stretch until 2024. PAGASA also says El Nino can enhance the southwest monsoon and bring in rains.
Dahil napakainit ang temperatura ng dagat, so potential siya for tropical cyclone development. So since malayo yung tropical cyclone development na malapit sa ating lugar, malayo siya, minsan nagre-recurve siya. So kapag nagre-recurve siya, ang nangyayari, humahatak naman ito ng habagat, nakakapag-enhance ng habagat season. So maraming pag-uulan.
But the Weather Bureau is appealing to the public to still conserve water despite the possibility of heavy rains. Rafael Busano, ABS-CBN News.